So we opened with none other than Herb Alpert and Lonnie Hall. And one of the things I learned is that all roads seem to lead to Herb Alpert. It's amazing his influence, the awards he gives, the scholarships he gives, and then how that permeates its way through the entire music industry.
You saw a very well-seasoned artist that was just kind of taking us through the decades, almost the soundtrack of all of our lives and, as delivered by him.
Herb brings his wife of 50 years, Lonnie Hall, to the stage, and she takes us to Brazil. What was that like?
Anytime I think about that music, I just think about the vibrancy of where that music comes from, and I think about how it can be used to convey happiness, and it's just a celebration of life.
Let's go to our next concert, which was in the Jazz Club, and it was Ranky Tanky and Lisa Fisher. Ranky Tanky, of course, representing the Gullah culture, which are the cultures of the coastal southern states, mostly South Carolina, a little bit of Georgia, even down into Florida. And we learned a lot about that culture, both through music and storytelling that night. And then Lisa Fisher just adds a whole nother layer to it.
She's a dynamic singer, dynamic vocalist, and a performer. I think she has a particular magnetism that just lights up any stage that she's on.
This is a playful.
Booker T. Jones, Matthew Whitaker. What an incredible, dual generation evening. Hammond B3 front and center.
One of the things that I always think about when I see, two masters of this particular instrument is just how effortless they make it look.
Matthew Whitaker shreds the instrument, and Booker T. Jones sort of caresses the instrument. And finally, on that evening, two generations in the two halves of the concert, Matthew and then Booker T., but also Booker T and his son.
To see the generations kind of come together, and I know that it was very special for him to have somebody to share all of the things that music has meant to Booker T with his son, with the next generation, and really kind of take him all over the world. That connection together is really powerful.
And then, we had Delphio Marcellus talk about, being right in the center of a multi-generational family and at the center of all things jazz.
I mean, it was a party, I felt everything that they were doing, and they were having so much fun that it definitely translated to the audience. Nobody could stand still just listening to that energy.
Close on our night of two Cuban musicians, again, a multi-generational evening. Harold Lopez Nusa, who has lived his whole life in Cuba until just recently when he moved with his family to France. And then Eliadis Ochoa, who's had a kind of a global existence with Buena Vista Social Club and his own career.
Absolutely. He has a way of taking these stories and weaving them and putting them to music and creating a sonic tapestry that really weaves and tells all of the places that he's been to watch and experience a true master of his craft. Bring that and share that with the audiences. It's been a gift.
Geographically, we were, of course, we started in Los Angeles with a little bit of Brazil. We visited the far eastern seaboard in the southern states. We visited New Orleans. We visited Cuba. We really got a broad array of geography and culture. The theme of multiple generations, whether that's Booker T and his son, Booker T and Matthew Whitaker, Eliadis Ochoa and Harold Lopez Nusa. No other form celebrates the span of generations the way jazz does. In this festival, it was alive and clear on the stage, both in any given night, but also spread across the festival.
Not only do you have the younger generations that provide a youthful energy, there's so much learning that occurs also. across the generations, and I think that's always been important.
You know, it was a danceable jazz festival. We could have danced all night, every night for each of these concerts. That was really the prevalent feeling for this year's festival. It was like a party here at the Soraya all 7 nights.
This jazz concert is returning to its roots by really celebrating its connection to movement and dance and all of those things.
Can you